Over the past few years, I've come to realize that for me, true wellness begins at home. Through the process of mindful decluttering and creating a more intentional space, I learned a lot about myself. For one, when my home is messy, so is my brain. A cluttered space amplifies my anxiety, it impairs my focus, and it has a way of throwing me off alignment in so many other areas of my life. It's kind of a ripple effect. But when my home is clean and put together, I feel energized and empowered to take on the day. A tidy, organized, and peaceful home gives me more mental space to breathe, think, move, create, and it sets me up to make healthier choices. So today I want to share with you 7 tips for creating a more peaceful home. Here we go. Number 1, embrace open spaces. I love the saying, clear space, clear mind, because it's absolutely true. When you keep your surfaces clean and minimal, it opens up the room and makes it feel lighter. I used to think I needed to have every appliance I owned displayed on my counter. Now I just store away anything I don't use that often, like my toaster. I also use lots of bins and organizers to make it easier to access what I need and to keep it organized. Number 2, use plants as decor. Rather than buying decorative knickknacks that just take up space and have no real function, consider decorating with plants. Plants are beautiful, they make you feel good, and they are a low-cost way to add life and color to a space. There are also many studies out there that link houseplants to improved mood and focus. So bring it on, the more the merrier. Number 3, give everything a home. To quote the queen of decluttering, Marie Kondo says, "Clutter is caused by a failure to return things to where they belong." So when you give everything a home, you make it easier to access it when you need it, as well as put it away when you don't. Getting rid of items that don't have anywhere to go or are hardly ever used will help clear the clutter and make tidying up a much easier task. Which brings me to my next point. Number 4, tidy up daily. When you get into the habit of putting things back where they belong each day, this helps prevent a giant buildup later. I do a quick tidy up to reset my space as part of my morning routine. I make my bed, put away the dishes, pick up dog toys, and these simple acts help me get centered for the day ahead, while making my home feel very zen. Number 5, style with calming neutrals. Colors have the power to affect how we feel and even how we act. This theory is called color psychology. For our home, we started with a neutral color palette of white and beige and then mixed in different textures. We focused on the green from our plants as our main color and then added a few more color pops that complement it. To keep things feeling clean and calm, I avoid busy prints or too many patterns because it can overstimulate a smaller space and even cause you to feel overwhelmed. Less is certainly more in this scenario. Number 6, soak up the natural light. Sunshine is a natural mood and energy booster, and it's actually the first quality I fell in love with when we found our house. If it's possible, open up your shades in the morning to let the light into your eyes and into your home. If your home doesn't get a lot of natural light, then all of the tips I shared in this video will certainly help to lighten and open up the space. Last but not least, number 7, let in fresh air. According to the US Environmental Protection Agency, indoor air is often more polluted than outdoor air. Opening up your windows for even just 5 minutes a day will let fresh air move through your home, help decrease indoor air pollutants, and it will allow you to reconnect to the outdoors. There you have it, my friends. I hope these tips will help inspire you to create your own calming retreat at home. The more thought you put into what you allow into your space, the more you'll be able to curate a minimal and intentional home that makes you feel calm and cozy. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to subscribe, and I'd love to hear from you in the comments. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.